own startup, or is it you just want some information? So how many startups we have out of this? None? Okay, great. So well, anyway, so I'll just talk about Electropreneur Park. So it's basically is a project which is funded by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Then STPI and ISA are the other stakeholders in this project. And STPI is the managing partner for Electropreneur Park project. So we have two programs. One is for the incubation, which is 12 to 18 months of where we give a fixed space all to all the startups. We give 5 seats to any startup which is getting incubated at Electropreneur Park. And the virtual acceleration program has all the other benefits except the fixed office space. So any startup which is based out of a city like Bangalore or a city which is more than 200 kilometers away from Delhi, so we have the option of taking them under a virtual acceleration program. So virtual acceleration program is a fixed 12 months program, a very focused program basically to help the startups. So we are not very old. So we were formally inaugurated on 27th of August 2016 by Honorable Minister Shri Ravi Shankar Prasad. So this is broadly, you know, the objective which we are working on. It's a 5-year project which is funded by ministry, and thereafter we'll be working on a self-sustenance mode. So for the first 5 years, we are targeting to incubate about 50 startups. We are focused on only ESDM sector. So we don't incubate, you know, startups which are in the software or in the service segment. So what we expect is any startup which is wanting to develop its own electronic product is where we can add a lot of value, and we can, you know, assist them really to develop that product. So that's the reason. So we focus on incubating the startups working in this field. So there is a lot of emphasis on IP creation, because for the products, you know, especially electronic product, when you are developing a product, the IP plays a very important role, because a lot of times if a startup is really working without filing a IP or without actually checking that whether the IP already exists for that product. So when they grow and they become a 40, 50 crore rupees company, so then they could have issues on somebody else claiming that, you know, there is an infringement on the IP. We have Delhi University as the academic partner for this project. So this is broadly is what, you know, is very important for any startup. You know, this is what actually we offer. So there is a power and the RF lab, which is fully equipped. The list of the equipments are on our website, and I have on the next slide also. You can just go through that. So there is a fast prototyping facility within Electropreneur Park. So there are 3D printers, there is a PCB prototyping machine, and then there are a few other equipments. Then there is a design and simulation tools, the softwares, various softwares, whether it is the PCB designing or whether it is the LabVIEW NI, which you need to use for designing. So we have that, all that in Electropreneur Park. We have the basic EMI and EMC and safety testing systems in place. For example, if you want to do a surge test, what we want is actually, you know, what happens is a lot of companies, they develop a electronic product, and once they have developed the product and then they go to the market and it sometimes fails in the field trials. So the idea of having some basic facility, for example, you want to carry out a vibration testing, so it should be available in the lab. So when you have even, you know, the second prototype which you prepare, you should be able to make a prototype which complies or which is able to absorb various shocks. You know, you can do a surge test, you can do the basic EMI, EMC test on that. So that basic facility, it's not an advanced facility for EMI, EMC, but the basic facility, yes, it exists. And there are a few equipments which we are adding to make sure that all the products which are going out can be easily certified in the labs. Then we have development kits, various development kits at Electropinner Park. We have about 10,000 square feet space. It's a 70-seater incubation center. And so when we give 5 seats to every startup, so we can accommodate up to 14 startups within the premises. And of course, there are many more startups under the virtual acceleration program, which we plan to accommodate. Virtual acceleration program we recently launched. So far, for the first few lot, we have just, we had started with the incubation program. Then important is also the library of the various standards, because what we are focusing on is to create global companies. So we feel that, you know, you should have access to the various standards when you're designing your product. Then there is a library of the reference design. You know, this is coming from various ESDM partners in the ecosystem. Then we have experts on the panel who are available as and when a startup needs their help. The EMI EMC expert, the PCB design expert, then technical support by the ESDM industry is arranged from time to time. Then, of course, most important, we provide funding assistance. So, you know, in the next few slides, I'll talk about, you know, what we have done on the funding part for the various startups. And very important is the marketing and the industry connect, because ISA, with a very strong, I would say, relationship within the industry, so we are able to tap into the resource, and we get a lot of industry experts and exposure for the startups. So these are just a list of you know, few equipments like signal generators, signal analyzers, spectrometer, even the basic tools like soldering iron is also available. Even a screwdriver is also available. So you actually don't have to bring in anything with you when you come to Electropinner Park. We put a lot of focus on the mentoring of the startups. So there are strategic mentors, there are master mentors, there are functional domain mentors, and there are international mentors in the pool. We have a pool of about 30 mentors. And the kind of people who actually mentor the startups here is, like, for example, one of the startup is getting mentored by Vice President of Murata. One startup is getting mentored by Vice President of NXP. One startup is getting mentored by Jaswinder from Jaswinder Ahuja, Managing Director of Cadence. Then one is the chairman of Global Foundries. So these are the kind of the mentors which we provide to the startups. So these mentors actually just give strategic guidance. So they meet once in a month, or they at least they are in touch over the phone. So there is a video conference or audio conference which is arranged, and these mentors give a strategic guidance to all these startups. So besides that, we hold a lot of regular workshops at Electropinner Park for the various startups. So we have a network of venture funds, angel investors, seed investor, whom we approach from time to time for supporting these startups with the investment. As part of the program, we don't give seed money immediately onboarding, but yes, we definitely have the network, and you get access to the all that network, and we facilitate various meetings among startup and the investors. And then, of course, the marketing connect. So these are a few of the benefits we have just listed. This is not a comprehensive list, but these are just a few benefits we listed. For example, assistance in IP filing, so it's at a very reduced rate. Then a credit from Amazon of $5,000. Then we are also tapping into the CSR funds from the industry. So each startup, for the initial prototyping cost, you know, they can really get some reimbursements of the various components which they have purchased, or you know, if they need some specific tools which are only required for their development, that again we can provide through the CSR funds. Then, of course, sponsor participation in various seminars and exhibition. So this is what Electropinner Park has done in last 1.5 years. So if you are interacting with the various startups, or you are part of a startup, so in 1.5 years, we have total about, right now, about 13 startups are associated with us. Out of that, 10 are under incubation, and the other are under, one is under exit now, and two are under pre-incubation. So out of the 10 startups which have been working for just about 1 year to maximum 1.5 year, So this is the result. So about total 7 new products have been created, 9 IPs have been filed from Electropreneur Park, 5 startups have been funded. So the range is from 40 lakh rupees to 2 crore rupees. They have been able to generate a revenue of 6 crores. So in a very small period of time of 1.5 year put together, generation of 6 crore is really a remarkable performance by all the startups. Just to give you an idea about what kind of startups we have, so that you can, you know, relate to what you are doing. For example, StemRobo, you know, joined us last year. They've been with us now almost about 13 months. So they are now supplying these STEM education kits to 65 schools all over India. They have reached a turnover of 1.5 CR. They have got external funding of 50 lakh. They have been selected under Atal Tinkering Labs by Niti Aayog. So we've actually, being a government incubator, so there is a lot of help which we can do, you know, when they are actually approaching the government agencies. So one is that definitely the brand value is there, the credibility is there, and then on top of that, we also assist them in grabbing, you know, some contracts from the government. Then Univ Labs is building a medical equipments and accessories for endoscopy, insulin management. You know, they are also building up insulin patch pump. They have already got a grant of about 50 lakh rupees from BIREC, and all additional grant from MSME of about 7.5 lakh rupees. They have already sold about 800 units of the light source, one of the unit which they developed. They have about 35 distributors. Also filed patents. iAutomation, again, is just, they onboarded with us about 8 months back. They have already doing a ton, or they have already booked orders of 1.5 CR. Now the product is not ready yet, but they have done order booking. So they have actually closed the deals with 4 clients, which are big builders. So this is for the building automation system. So each order value is about 35, 40 lakh rupees. So they've already booked 4 orders, and they will be supplying now starting next month. EVA technology, again, this is one of the very important upcoming field, is the e-mobility. So they are encashing this opportunity. So they are building a DC-based charging station for electric vehicles. They've already, again, they have done an order booking of about 1.2 CR for 70 units. The product is ready, and the first delivery has happened just about 4 days back. Then this Star Brew is working in the tactical Android wireless. They are building a tactical Android wireless data cards for defense segment. They've already got an order of about 60 units. Now they are just working on trying to get a big order from defense. And plus they are also getting a funding from SIDBI for about 1 CR. This is under the TIFEX scheme. Then Resonant Electronics, they are building IoT-based wireless retrofit energy audit and control systems for basically energy management. So they have already built part of the product, which they have monetized. So they are selling the panels right now, and the central unit, and of course the software is almost ready now. They have already started the field trials for this product, and they shall be actually formally launching a full-fledged solution by end of February. They have already received again a funding of about 38 lakh rupees. It's now, they are funded by one of the Japanese companies, and this is again, we facilitated that interaction, and they received a funding of 38 lakh. They are already doing also a turnover of almost about 40 lakh from the product which they have already developed. Then Durasta Analytics, working on unique energy monitoring for microgrids, basically, which are installed in various villages. So they have already also done the field trials, and there is a pilot project which they already completed. So now there's the full-fledged order, first order, they are in the process of execution. Fit Nanotechnology is working on the smart attendance system for schools. Then the Sientra technology working on the vehicle health, fleet management. Simply Purify is a recently added startup, been with us only about 6 months. So they are in a prototype stage. So they are also trying to build a unique product in the area of air purifiers and also the monitoring systems. So these are the few of the initiatives which we took to promote our startups. Now again, is a long list. I've just listed few of them. So as we speak right now, two of the startups of Electropinner Park right now have gone with Secretary of Ministry of Electronic Information Technology to UK as part of the delegation. So that is the kind of, you know, opportunities the startup of Electropinner Park are getting. So you know, there is an event, Innovate 2017. So they are part of a 10-member delegation, and they are getting a lot of global exposure. And last night I had a word with them, and they are also you know, able to establish some global contact for future supply of the products. Again, I listed few other initiatives to promote our startups. All our startups, like there was a stall at Thai Global Summit in Delhi last year. So all our startup got an opportunity to display their product, do a lot of networking within the industry. Then of course, the various pitching sessions which we take them to. These are again few events which we actually have sponsored for the startups. So they don't have to pay for any participation cost. This event we organized last month on 26th October 2017. So few pictures from that. So one of the picture, the startup is getting an award. So one startup got an award of 3 lakh rupees by Next Orbit Ventures. Then there were sessions with the investors. There were sessions with the industry expert. All the startups got an opportunity to make a pitch to not only the investors, but also to the industry, so that they can also build some collaborations within the industry. These are few of the mentoring workshops. So there is a focus on all around development of the startups at Electropinner Park. So there are technical workshops. Technical workshops are actually happening now almost about 3 to 4 days in a month. Like, you know, we had a workshop last week on STM32 conducted by ST Microelectronics. We are going to have a workshop on, you know, basically the mobility sector for autonomous vehicles by Infineon this week. And again, we have another workshop planned by ST on around 16th of next month. So every month we have 3 to 4 technical workshops. Then there are various business mentoring workshops, tools like financial planning, the digital marketing, the various, you know, opportunities for connecting within the industry. So we call various industry experts, so that our startups can get a market connect, so they can really, you know, interact with these people and explore the opportunity, you know, to collaborate and sell the products. Then of course, again, frequent workshops on how to file the IPs. So coming to the program, so in case, you know, there is a startup which is based out of Bangalore, so it has got two options, either to apply for an incubation program or to apply for a virtual acceleration program. So in case a startup in Bangalore applies for an incubation program, so there is an equity. The key difference is on the space and the equity. So like any startup which is joining the program, so we don't charge anything for the space. There are no space rentals. Startup doesn't have to pay anything for using the lab. So the startup has to just share an equity in the company. So depending on, so what is the current status of the startup? For example, if it is a new startup, somebody has just started, so there is no value actually. So I mean, there is no valuation, and he's just put in maybe 1 lakh rupees and started. So then we will ask for a 10% equity in that kind of startup. But now there are startups which have already established. They are doing some business. So there is a turnover, there is some profit, or maybe somebody invest, the promoters have already put in their own money of, let's say, about 20, 25 lakh rupees. So in such cases, we reduce the equity to 5%. Now that is for the incubation program. Now, if we are talking about virtual acceleration program is a fixed 12-month program. So a startup avails all the facility which I talked about, except the space. So a startup in this case has to give half of the equity. For example, if it's a fresh startup, new startup, which anybody is starting, so he will have to share 5% equity. But if it's again an established startup, then he has to share only 2.5% of equity, which I think 2.5% equity for even an established startup and the kind of the mentoring he gets from Electropreneur Park and to access to the various opportunities, you know, to grow is immense. So I think that that's should be very attractive for any startup based out of, you know, Bangalore or other cities. So you could be at a different stages. Maybe you have a, we need to have a established proof of concept. You may be building a prototype, you maybe have the product ready, you're looking some marketing connects, or maybe you're looking at business mentoring, or you're looking at maybe an opportunity to get the exposure and the opportunities, you know, which we present in, as part of the program to various startups. So you can apply for that. So for incubation, we expect 12 to 18 months, the startup should be out. For acceleration, it's a fixed 12 months program. I think that is all, and I'll invite any questions if anyone has. Okay. Started 7 years back and you've been a service company and you have not developed any product and now you want to develop a product. Is that the? So you are developing, we have as such, we have no problem. In case you feel that you need this kind of assistance, you're most welcome to apply. Now, if you do not fall into the startup definition, so what is the turnover? Like if your turnover is, let's say, more than 2 crore rupees, then you have already reached a stage where we expect a startup to actually exit, right? But in case you are applying for a virtual acceleration program, so what is the turnover, may I ask? Less than 1 crore. So 2 crore is the limit which we look at. So you can always apply for a virtual acceleration program, right? So you may not be able to avail the benefits which comes under Startup India program, because that's where the 7-year condition is. As far as we are concerned, so for us, the years is not important. It's important is the turnover and at what stage of the product development you are. You're selling. Okay. Okay. So you are developing a series of other products, right? So you will need assistance. So what we want is that you should see the value, that that's important for us. And we also should see that we can contribute to your growth. So you can definitely apply. So basically our focus is on speeding up the development. I mean, being an incubation center, I think we feel that we have done a good job. If we can make the startup do the same job which he would have taken, let's say 3 years, within one and a half year. So that's where actually what we are focusing on. You know, that's the kind of guidance and the, you know, we want to give. That's the kind of assistance we want to give start to a startup. So we are not looking at startups who have, you know, to make one product, maybe they need 3 years, 4 years or 5 years. But yes, there are some deep tech technologies. So if you need about minimum 3 years or 4 years or 5 years, so, you know, your proposal will go through evaluation process. And if we find that actually your product is a deep tech startup, which will need more than 3 or 5 years, then of course it's the, you know, the evaluation team which decides that will it be right to take that startup, or maybe if we know or we are confident that yes, we can contribute to speed up your work, then we'll definitely like to consider such startups. Yeah, Rajiv Jain is from ISA. I'll just. So I believe to if you are registering a new company, and if there are, you know, the directors, the team is different, then it's fine. But if it is the same group of directors and you register a new company, so finally that application will be denied when you try to receive the benefits. So maybe you have more team which you want to get associated with, and you then you want to float a company. But then, yes, the team should be different. The promoter should be different. Not that everyone has to be different. There can be common directors. But as I understand, so you will need to have a few different people. So what we have done is, I'll explain there again, is that we don't have a full-fledged test laboratory that you can get a compliance straight away, and you, it's not that you will test it here and 100% you will comply. So what we are keeping those basic equipments that when you are actually building your product, so you can actually see that whether it will pass or not, first of all. Second is the expert we have for EMI, EMC. So he will also guide you that, okay, PCB designing, this is the way you should do the components placement, or you know, these components you should not use, so that overall guidance you will get. So for certification, we have like tied up right now with the URS lab. So at almost about 50% of the rates, of the market rates, you will be able to get your product tested if you again want a testing. Now if you want to go for UL certification from a UL lab, so they have their own fixed rates, so they will charge definitely the fixed rate. But the advantage is when you will actually submit your product, it will pass. So what happens generally, a lot of people, you know, they spend 4-5 lakh rupees and actually, you know, it fails, the product fails, and the money actually really goes for a waste. So that will probably not happen if you have taken care of and used the facility very well and the panel which we have. That's how, you know, we help on that. Yes. So government fee under Startup India, you get even lot of fees are waived off, in fact. So if you are registered under Startup India, then we have a panel of you know, legal companies who are giving almost 50% of the market rate, which as a startup, if you will approach maybe another IP filing firm of the same capabilities, so the, you know, what they will charge otherwise, it will be even less than 50% in some cases. That is under SIP scheme, if you are looking at. Right. So you should not delay it, actually. So what is your estimate of each patent filing cost? So in we our companies have filed patent at just about 20,000-25,000 rupees. So that's the kind of advantage you can get each patent. See, any other questions? Right.
Like for example, any spectrum analyzer, vector signal analyzer, is the facilities available in your?
So you said you are a service-based company.
Yeah.
But so the, what product you have then?
Not product.
You are buying the product from outside.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we have to test some RTL code in the FPGA, and you have to check and debug in the vector signal analyzer or DLA.
So right now the facility we are just giving to the incubated startups. So we have not opened the lab for access to any startup which is not under incubation or virtual acceleration program.
Okay.
So we will not be able to help there. But in case, yes, you are developing a product and you decide to take virtual acceleration, then once you have the lab access, we don't mind if you are testing, you know, your products.
For registering a new company, is the infrastructure
so can you speak slightly louder?
For registering as a new company, with the infrastructure will be provided by you.
So we have, again, we have on the panel people.
Okay.
So they will help you. We will guide you definitely. Okay. We are there to mentor you always. Okay. But as far as the fees are concerned, so you will have to pay fees, which will be again at a very, I would say, competitive rate.
Okay.
From these empaneled companies.
Okay.
Because when we empanel the company, we negotiate the rates for our startups.
Okay.
And we negotiate and try to make it, you know,
okay,
very, very competitive.
Okay.
From quality vendors. Besides this, for example, like if you want to buy components, you know.
Yeah.
So we have tied up with various distributors for the components. We have tied up with Element 14 also. So the minimum order quantity clause is removed. You can buy even one component. That too, we also arrange a lot of free samples, maybe some free development kits also. Time to time, we don't promise that every development kit is going to be free, but yes, there are few development kits where you know, we are able to convince the distributor, yes, there is a good opportunity, they should help. So our distributors have been giving now free kits or free samples to our startups. So almost about, I would say, there are some startups which have received more than 1 lakh rupees of free samples or free development kit from the distributor network which we have.
Okay.
Or where we interact, you know, very regularly.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other question? Okay, thank you very much. So please spread the word. In case there is any startup which is interested, please ask them to apply. We are now inviting applications. So we normally have seasons. Right now we are in the season 4. And we will be doing a selection process in the maybe first week of or second week of January. So if somebody is interested, this is the right time to apply, because then again we will be looking at a next batch after 6 months. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.